The third point is, let A equal to the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is, the set A contains 6 symbols. Consider the permutation F is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Second line 5, 1, 4, 3, 2, 6. Here I have highlighted with red color because 6 is a identity permutation, and hence this can be written as product of cycles. What are the cycles we have here? 1 goes to 5, 5 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1, 1 to 1. Therefore, the cycle will be 1, 5, 2. The another cycle is 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 3. Therefore, the cycle 3, 4. Then the identity permutation 6. That is equals to, these are the product of cycles. The first cycle is 1, 5, 2, 1. Second cycle is 3, 4. Third one is 6. That is equals to the cycles 1, 5, 2 and 3, 4. Since 6 is the identity permutation, it need not be shown. This also can be written as the product of the two cycles, namely 3, 4 and the cycle 1, 5, 2. Observe that the cycles 3, 4 and 1, 5, 2 are disjoint cycles because no element is common in these two cycles. Fourth point, let A equal to the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is, A has 6 elements. That is 6 symbols. Consider the permutation. The permutation which consists of product of 3 cycles or product of 3 transpositions. Therefore, it is an odd permutation because it has 3 transpositions. Whenever the number of transposition is odd, it is called odd permutation. Therefore, this F is an odd permutation. This can be written as 1, 2, 1, 3. Now we are going to write the cycle as a permutation in which 1 goes to 5, 5 goes to 1. What about rest of the 4 elements, namely 2, 3, 4, 6? They are all identity permutations. Therefore, the cycle 1, 5 can be written as 1 goes to 5, 5 goes to 1. 2 goes to 2, 3 goes to 3, 4 goes to 4, 6 goes to 6. Because they are all identity permutation. Now we are going to write the cycle 1, 3 as a permutation. That is equals to 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1, 2 goes to 2, image of 4 is 4, image of 5 is 5, image of 6 is 6. Now we are going to multiply these two permutations. Whenever we multiply two permutations, generally we rearrange the columns of the second permutation so as to have the first line of second permutation is equals to second line of the first permutation. We are going to rearrange the columns of this permutation. We have rearranged the columns of the second permutations as 3, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6, which is exactly same as the second line of the permutation. Let us verify whether the images are kept correctly or not. 3 goes to 3, image of 2 is 2, image of 1 is 5, image of 4 is 4, image of 5 is 1, image of 6 is 6. Yes, we have written the corresponding images correctly. We can cancel the second line of the first permutation with the first line of the second permutation. And hence we get the cycle 1, 2. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and this one 3, 2, 5, 4, 1, 6. Yes. Now we are going to multiply these two. This is your permutation. This is a cycle. We are going to write the cycle as a permutation. This cycle says that 1 goes to 2. Therefore, the image of 1 will be 2. Image of 2 will be 1. Whereas for the rest of the elements, namely 3, 4, 5, 6, they have their corresponding images as themselves. That is equals to 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1. So 3 goes to 3, 4 goes to 4, 5 goes to 5, 6 goes to 6. Now we are going to multiply these two permutations. Therefore, we are going to rearrange the columns of the second permutation. This is the one we have done it here. The second line of first permutation is 2, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also we have 2, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let us verify their images. 2 goes to 2. Yes, 2 goes to 2. 1 goes to 3. 1 goes to 3. Image of 3 is 5. Yes, image of 3 is 5. Image of 4 is 4. Yes, 4 is 4. 5 is 1. Image of 5 is 1. Image of 6 is 6. Image of 6 is 6. Right. Now we are going to cancel the second line of the first permutation and the first line of the second permutation. Therefore, this is equals to the permutation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here it is 2, 3, 5, 4, 1, 6. We are going to write this as product of cycles once again. That is equals to 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 5, 5 goes to 1. Whereas 4 goes to 4, 6 goes to 6, they are identity permutations. Therefore, it is 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 5, 5 goes to 1. Therefore, the product of the cycles 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5 is equals to the cycle 1, 2, 3, 5. Now, look at this. This is a very important point. Very often, we are going to use while doing problems. The product of 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5 is 1, 2, 3, 5. That is 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3. 3 goes to 5. This is how we write. The product of the cycles 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5 can be written as starting with 1, write the rest of the elements 2, 3, 5. Similarly, what is the product of 1, 3, 1, 5, 1, 4, 1, 6? We are going to write this as a single cycle that is equals to 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 5, 5 goes to 4, 4 goes to 6, 6 goes to 1. That is 1, 3, 5, 4, 6. Definition of even and odd permutations. We know that a cycle of length 2 is called a transposition. A permutation is said to be an even or odd permutation if it can be expressed as a product of even or odd number of transpositions. For example, alpha is equals to the permutation 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1. We are going to write this as product of transpositions. When you say transposition, it must be a cycle of length 2. It is clear that 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1. Therefore, this is a cycle 1, 2, 3. But this is not a transposition. What is a transposition? A cycle of length 2. But this is a cycle of length 3. Therefore, this cycle should be written as product of transpositions. Just now, we learned how to write a cycle as a product of transpositions. This can be written as the product 1, 2, then 1, 3. That is equals to 1, 2, 1, 3. Alpha is equals to 1, 2, 3 is equals to the product of the cycles or the product of transpositions 1, 2, 1, 3. This is the one just now we have learned. 1, 2, 3, 5 is written as product of the transpositions 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5. Similarly, 1, 3, 5, 4, 6 can be written as 1, 3, then 1, 5, 1, 4, 1, 6. Thus, 1, 2, 3 is written as 1, 2, 1, 3. So, it can also be expressed as 1, 3, 2, 3. Both the same. Both are one and the same. The justification is here. We are going to verify that the cycle 1, 2, 3 is equals to the product of the cycles 1, 3 and 2, 3. So, 1, 3 into 2, 3. Consider the product of transpositions 1, 3, 2, 3. That is equals to, we are going to write this cycle or this transposition as a permutation. Therefore, here 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1, and hence 2 is the identity permutation. Now, the cycle 2, 3 or the transposition 2, 3 can be written as the permutation 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, because 1 goes to 1, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 2. We are going to multiply these two permutations. We know how to multiply. So, that is equals to, we are rearranged the columns of the second permutation so that first line of the second permutation is equal to the second line of the first permutation, and hence these two get cancelled. We get 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, and this can be written as 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3 and 3 goes to 1. Therefore, this is a cycle that goes from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1. That is equals to 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1. Thus, the product of the transpositions 1, 3, 2, 3 is same as the cycle 1, 2, 3. Therefore, the alpha is equals to 1, 2, 3 can be written as 1, 2, 1, 3 or 1, 2, 2, 3. Thus, the cycle 1, 2, 3 of length 3, because it has 3 elements, has been expressed as the product of transpositions in 2 ways, and in both of them the number is even. Yes, this is cycle 1, 2, 3, which has product of 2 transpositions, namely 1, 2 is 1 transposition. The another transposition is 1, 3. That is 2. The 2 is even. Same alpha equals to 1, 2, 3 can be written as the transposition 1, 3 and 2, 3. That is, there are 2 transpositions. That is, the number is even. Therefore, the given permutation alpha is even permutation. Consider the permutation F is equals to 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 3. This can be written as a cycle 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 3. Therefore, this is a cycle 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 5, 5 goes to 6, 6 goes to 3. Now, this can be written as product of transpositions. Transposition is a cycle of length 2. Just now we have learned how to write a cycle as a product of transpositions. So this cycle can be written as 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. That is, F is written as product of 3 transpositions. 3 is an odd number. Therefore, F is expressed as an odd number of transpositions. Therefore, F is an odd permutation. Consider another example. The permutation G equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Their images are 2, 3, 1, 5, 4 respectively. This can be written as a cycle. Here the cycle is 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1. 4 goes to 5, 5 goes to 4. Therefore, this becomes a product of 2 cycles, in which the first cycle will be 1, 2, 3, second cycle will be 4, 5. This is the one. 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1, 4 goes to 5, 5 goes to 4. Now, this is a transposition. We need not disturb this. But this is a cycle. This cycle has to be written as product of transpositions. We know how to write a cycle as a product of transpositions. So this can be written as the product of transpositions as 1, 2, 1, 3. This also can be written as the transpositions 1, 2 and 2, 3. Therefore, G is expressed as product of 3 transpositions. That is, G is expressed as an odd number of transpositions because 3 is an odd number. Therefore, G is an odd permutation. Note number 1. From the above examples, we conclude that a cycle of length n can be expressed as a product of n minus 1 transpositions. Yes, this is a cycle of length 4, that is n equal to 4. This is a product of 3 transpositions. A cycle of length n can be expressed as a product of n minus 1 transpositions. If n is odd, then the cycle can be expressed as a product of even number of transpositions. Here n is odd. This is a cycle of length 3. So therefore, this can be expressed as 1, 2, 1, 3. Therefore, n is odd here. The number of transposition is even. Therefore, in a cycle, if n is odd, then we can have even number of transpositions. If n is even, then the cycle can be expressed as a product of odd number of transpositions. Just now we have discussed an example. This is a cycle of length 4. 4 is an even number. But this can be expressed as product of 3 transpositions. Here 3 is an odd number. Thus n equal to 4 here. But here the number of transposition is 3, that is odd. Therefore, if n is even, then the cycle can be expressed as a product of odd number of transpositions. If a permutation f is expressed as a product of transpositions, then either n is even or n is odd, but cannot be both, and n is not unique. Every transposition is an odd permutation, because in a transposition you will be having only two elements. For example, the transposition 1, 2. This is a transposition. It has only one transposition and hence it is an odd permutation. Identity permutation I is always an even permutation since I can be expressed as a product of two transpositions. For example, I is equals to 1, 2, 2, 1. This is a product of two transpositions. This also can be written as the cycles 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 1, 1, 3. Each cycle is a transposition. There are four transpositions and hence it is an even permutation. The fifth point is the product of two odd permutations is an even permutation. The product of two even permutation is an even permutation. The product of an odd permutation and an even permutation is an odd permutation. The inverse of an odd permutation is an odd permutation. The inverse of an even permutation is an even permutation. Multiplication of disjoint cycles is commutative. Every permutation can be uniquely expressed as a product of disjoint cycles. Every permutation can be expressed as a product of transpositions in many ways. Every cycle can be expressed as a product of transpositions in many ways. Now we will discuss some examples. Examine the following permutations are even or odd. The first one, f is equals to the cycle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a cycle having 5 elements. Therefore, the cycle of length 5 and hence it must have 4 transposition. Just now we discussed if a cycle has length n, then it will have n minus 1 transpositions. Here n is equal to 5. Therefore, this must have 4 transpositions, namely 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5. Therefore, F is expressed as a product of 4 transpositions. F is of length 5. It has 4 transpositions and hence F is an even permutation. Consider the second example. F is equal to the product of the cycles 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5. 4, 5 is a transposition. We need not disturb this. Therefore, consider the cycle 1, 2, 3. This is a cycle of length 3 and hence it must have 2 transpositions. And hence this cycle 1, 2, 3 can be expressed as a product of 2 transpositions as 1, 2, 1, 3. This is 4, 5. And hence F is a product of 3 transpositions. And hence F has 3 transpositions. 3 is an odd number. Therefore F is an odd permutation. Consider another example. The permutation G equals to the first line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, second line 3, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. Now we are going to check whether the given permutation is even or odd. For that, we have to express the given permutation as product of transposition. We can see here number 2 is a identity permutation, whereas the rest of the numbers forms a cycle, that is starts from 1, 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 5, 5 goes to 6, 6 goes to 7, 7 goes to 1. Therefore, the above permutation is a cycle, namely 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 5, 5 goes to 6, 6 goes to 7, 7 goes to 1. We have to express this cycle as a product of transposition. We know how to write a cycle as a product of transposition. That is, this can be written as the product of transpositions, namely 1, 3, then 1, 4, then 1, 5, then 1, 6, then 1, 7. This is the one. 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7. So each one is a transposition because each one is a cycle of length 2. And we know that a cycle of length 2 is a transposition. How many transpositions are there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 transpositions. That is, G is expressed as a product of 5. 5 is an odd number, that is 5 transposition, and hence the given permutation is an odd permutation. That is, G has 5 transpositions, so G is an odd permutation. Consider another permutation H on 9 symbols, because the last number is 9. For clarity's sake, I highlighted the identity permutations in blue color. That is, the numbers 7, 8 and 9, they all identity permutation. Therefore, we don't consider those numbers while writing a cycle. And the rest of the numbers will form a cycle. That is, 1 goes to 6, 6 goes to 5, 5 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1. That is one cycle. The other cycle is 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 3. And hence, H can be expressed as a product of 2 cycles. This is the one. 1, 6. 6 goes to 5. 5 goes to 2. 2 goes to 1. Then another one is 3 goes to 4, 4 goes to 3. Simply, we have mentioned the identity permutation 7, 8, 9, but we need not mention them. Therefore, that is equals to the product of 2 cycles. If we consider the second cycle, it is already a transposition. Therefore, now we have to write the first cycle as a product of transposition. therefore that is equals to 1 6 1 5 1 2. The last one is 3 4. Therefore H has 4 transpositions, or H is expressed as a product of 4 transpositions. 4 is an even number, and hence H is an even permutation. That is, H has 4 transpositions, so H is an even permutation.